earlier this year, I had created two smaller pieces that were both titled Guided. And creating those pieces was my response to seeing the murder of George Floyd by police. As an artist, I like listening to social commentary by YouTubers, especially black content creators. And I felt it was really impactful to hear what black men had to say over the issue and talk about George Floyd as well as other instances of police brutality that affect black people nationally and globally, and how they also spoke about black on black crime and violence. And I felt like the common thread I saw or heard in listening to their videos or those videos was how important it was for black men to know who they are in this world, find their purpose, and become builders that help influence all black people from different communities. And I felt very encouraged because, you know, it was the incentive they had to encouraging other black men to be purposeful made me think of creating a series and using the word guided to represent that. So that's how Black Male Guided came to be. In my work, I like researching different symbols and possibly creating my own. And so when I had done a geometric drawing that was before the pandemic, I had utilized an indigenous symbol that's native to Ghana that represents change, transformation, and reflection and character. And so I was really inspired by that symbol and wanted to modify it in a way that would make it unique to me when I utilize it in my work. And so I utilized hands to help adjust the symbol to make it different for me. And so I wanted to repurpose the geometric drawing and create two sketches with including portraits and portraits of black men. And so I was playing around with it compositionally until the portrait as well as the pattern and symbol made sense and looked good together. And so while doing so, I noticed that it looked like a halo surrounding the black men that I depicted. And it wasn't something that I did intentionally, but while looking at the images, it was something that I really loved and wanted to keep. And for me, growing up, Catholic and seeing stained glass images showcasing different religious or biblical events. The way that the sketches came together almost reminded me of that. And that was something that I really love. And in continuing this series, it's something that I would hope to utilize in some way. So the process I use in creating new work depends on the nature of the project that I have going on. So I did these paintings on my own, but originally for the City Artist Corps grant, I wanted for the pieces to be done collaboratively and to involve participants painting the work with me, and then for me as an artist to just finalize any, you know, sort of details before exhibiting it. So my schedule became really busy, so I had to create the images myself, but the framework that I used to prepare myself to create the images, to create the sketches, and transfer it into the canvases that I use, which happen to both be 3x4 feet dimension. I wanted to resemble the template for the paint by number so wanting to have specific areas that would be designated certain colors that would make it easier for others to paint with me, for that original idea of making it a collaborative painting project. But in doing it myself, that process became extremely helpful for me. Ordinarily, I do create sketches before my works, but they're very loose sketches and they're not always as detailed and colored in. So thinking that I was gonna do something collaborative and preparing for that actually helped me more as an artist. And I think moving forward, it's a process that I hope to continue, whether or not I work with others or continue to work on my own. So I wish to continue the series by making it more personal and making it more research-based. In creating these two pieces, I referenced images of Black men that I found online. It's usually a practice that I do when I'm making pieces that are outside of creating a story around referencing images of people that I do know. So for this project, I felt that it would be necessary for me to get in contact with my friends who are Black men and to moderate some type of focus group, leading conversations and discussions that I feel would be important or necessary for Black men to talk about. And then from having that, I would love to utilize the information gained from that to create new pieces that feel more, that are more reflective of the stories of Black men that I know and come across. By being awarded the City Artist Corps grant, I learned that I can grow more as an artist. I feel more capable of gaining the skill set that curators I admire and have worked with have in creating an idea and then generating a proposal for an art exhibition. And so I would love to apply to more grants. I feel more confident in doing so, as well as maintaining and deepening my relationships with art institutions such as JCAL.